either not being bullied. If you're being bullied, how to deal with it. And make sure you're not the one bullying anybody. Okay, it's not a good thing. And I can go on about it, but I'm not. That's why I brought this guy here. He's a good, near, dear friend of ours. We grew up with him. He happened to play high school football when me and Coach was playing high school basketball. We graduated around the same time. He's a member of the Albany Police Department right now, and he does a lot with still helping out with kids. He's a school liaison that deals with the youth and helping out and do a lot of things. So I've known this gentleman for a very, very long time, and he's been a good friend of our program, a good friend of ours personally. So we brought up Mr. Cancer in to come in and talk to you guys and share a couple things with you about bullying, all right? So you can understand what that entails and what's going on with that whole piece. So as you come, would you give guys a hand? Give Mr. Cancer a hand.
How y'all doing? Well, as you said, I'm Officer Cancer. I know I don't look like it now, but one of the guys was in it, but I am a police officer. I'm assigned at Albany High School as a school liaison officer. Well, we're here for bullying, anti-bullying, certain things about the severities of kids being bullied in today's society. I know there's been big bustling on the news about kids being bullied, and the reaction to the bullying has caused kind of catastrophic severities to other children inside the schools. Bullying is a big thing in this country. They're trying to pass laws where they're going to start having it become a felony offense. Cyberbullying, Facebook, Twitter, kids are targeting each other on Twitter, targeting each other on Facebook. Simple things of saying, you know, the kid did this or he smells bad, and just constantly amping and banging on kids. They're gonna start really hammering people for doing that. How many of you have been bullied? How many of you are the ones that bully? Wow. Well, I'm gonna give you a brief what's the name, and this is for parents as well. You know, it's a little something. So children always enjoyed learning. You know, if your child always enjoyed learning, I mean, but lately seemed anger and to avoid school. You know, kids always just some stomach aches. Your kid's mysterious illness pop up in the evening and seem to get worse as the school bus creeps closer to the street the next morning. It's possible the problem has nothing to do with how last night's dinner was digested. Your child could be worried sick over a schoolyard bully. Bullies can take the fun out of school. Where bullying happens most, it turns something simple like riding the bus every day, stopping at his locker, walk into the bathroom, and turn into a scary event that's anticipated with worry all day. Children who are bullied often experience low self-esteem and depression, whereas those doing the bullying may go on to engage in more destructive antisocial behaviors as teens and adults. Bullies who often have been bullied themselves may pick on others to feel powerful, popular, important, or in control. Often they antagonize the same children repeatedly. Sadly, bullying is widespread. According to a Kids Health and Kids poll, 86% of more than 1,200 students, 9 to 13-year-old boys and girls polled, said they've seen someone else being bullied, and 48% said they've been bullied, and 42% admitted to bullying other kids at least once in a while. This is a major epidemic. I mean, there's a lot of ways of talking to people. There's plenty of social workers, plenty of school staff, school liaison officers. I mean, anytime you feel like you've been bullied or someone's picking on you. Something simple, that's where it starts. You know, the same kid constantly bobbing and pushing you. There's always ways for you to, always people to come to to help you out.
Just give some ideas of what they should look for when they
just you know, the kids that's targeting is the bigger kids. It's one kid that's constantly pushing you, asking you for money, you know, punching on you for no apparent reason. Those sort of things. You know what I mean? I know we've all seen it. Who's go tell? Always tell someone. You either witness someone getting bullied or see a person, a friend of yours, constantly getting picked on, crying. Because all it does to the child is really it devastating. They don't want to come to school. And sometimes often when you get to the border, end up some kids commit suicide.
Yeah.
Or some kids come in and do damage to a lot of, you know, other kids that have nothing to do with what was going on.
And the reason why it's important to recognize bullying, the reason why I thought to come up with this, Coach and I to come up with this idea of doing an anti-bullying camp, because I was bullied when I was a kid as well. But here's the thing. I used to always just think bullying was somebody taking your lunch money or somebody putting you under pressure. Right, Torres, can you please sit up? Go ahead. Different friends and stuff. Good, because you talking about my point I was about to make. That's the point I was just about to make, was that bullying is not just a form of somebody. The reason why people don't like to say they've been bullied, because it kind of, to them, it means like somebody is, like you in fear or you're scared of someone. But it takes on a different tone. Bullying is also, is when you talk about somebody all the time. So I didn't have the best clothes when I was growing up. So when I came to school, I was picked on about what I was wearing and what I had on. It made me feel bad about myself. That's why Officer Cancer is talking about your self-esteem being low, because somebody starts talking about you all the time. And guess what? A form of bullying that you don't even realize is when you start laughing at the person along with when somebody's talking about them. Then you're bullying them too, all right? Because that person feels bad about themselves and they don't feel good about themselves, and that's not a good thing. And we've seen situations where a couple years ago, when it was Schenectady High, it was like four girls.
No, Schenectady.
Schenectady High, like four girls committed suicide. Because they were being picked on. So it's like serious stuff, because like with the social aspect of all this stuff with Facebook and everything, imagine somebody saying something to you. Not only just these 12 or 13 people in the room know about it or said something about you, but everybody knows it. So now when everybody sees you, they're pointing at you and talking about you. How would you think that would make you feel? How would that make you feel? Somebody tell me, how would that make you feel? Go ahead, don't be scared for it. Go ahead. Make you feel sad? Bad? Angry? So, go ahead. Disappointed? Yep. So that's why I brought him in to talk to you guys. That don't be so two things. Don't be a part of bullying nobody, and don't be afraid to report bullying. You're not no punk, you're not no chump, you're not no snitch, you're not none of that stuff. Alright? Because the main focus at the end of the day is to get what when you go to school? Education. If there's anybody that's in the way of your education, you need to make sure that they don't remain in your way. So that's why I want to definitely take the time out. I hope you guys learned something from this. And encourage your friends. If your friends are being bullied, encourage them. Encourage them. But most of all, don't be a part of bullying. It's more than just taking something from somebody. It's more than that. Okay? There's a lot more than that. So we want you guys to get an education and go to school and if you see people encouraging, because a lot of times the problem we're seeing is that we see that people think it's cool to take somebody else's manhood, so to speak. So, you know, you hear people say, this is my little son right here. This is my little son. But they want to have power over them. You don't want nobody to have no power over you. You don't want nobody to have no power over you. That's not cool. Let everybody be their own individual. You don't want to have power over nobody and let nobody have power over you. You understand that? So that's why I had Officer Campbell come out and talk to you guys about the gangster bully. That's why we do this on, so you guys can have fun and learn at the same time. Right. You want to give Officer Campbell a big hand?